Hello, Pisces. How are you doing? Welcome into your Wednesday reading, the 10th of November. We are going to call in your spirit guides now to come into my spirit room, please. And we're going to ask them to please guide the reading for us. We're going to ask them to give us some messages that we need to receive with regards to whatever is happening with you on Wednesday. And also advise us and give us direction at the end of the reading as well. So let's see for you, Pisces. What is going on? Your cards are just flipping. I think it happened last time in your reading as well. Let's see what wants to come out here, what messages want to come through, because they definitely have something to say. So let's see what's going on with you, Pisces, for Wednesday. Knight of Materials in the reverse position. There's a person here, the King or the Knight of Materials, their actions, very slow moving here. They are not really keeping up with the words that they're saying. So they may be promising you some kind of stability, but it's almost like you're seeing no action from them whatsoever. In that reverse position, be careful, because they may have done this before. The Three of Cups comes up here. You might be meeting somebody new here, because sometimes when I see the Three of Cups, it kind of reminds me of dating energy. This person, they're either extremely slow at getting to know somebody, or I've got this feeling of you like date somebody now and then you don't hear from them for a month. You know what I'm saying? Or like 2 weeks go by and you like maybe hear from them and then you're wondering, are we going to date each other again? And then randomly they come in and they're like, okay, do you want to go on a date again? This person is very slow, very, very slow with this. Page of, yes, like messages as well. Page of Inspiration. I don't know if this person is ready for a relationship. They're busy with other stuff here. Not necessarily other like people, but I mean like life and their own things, and they're too slow. That makes me feel like are they ready for a relationship? I feel like you're dating someone on and off, maybe messaging a person like long distance as well, but they're too slow. There's times where you're not hearing from them. And that's the problem. Even though then you hear from them and you have this time that you have together that you celebrate, you're happy, and then, you know, that message goes a bit slow again, you don't hear from them again. This is just way too slow. What is going on here? Where spirit guides, it's not like it's not bad. It's not bad with them, but there's no movements here. There's no, where is this going and when is it going to happen? Are you going to be on pension when you finally marry this person? What's going on here? It's too slow. How, you know, life is moving, people, you know. Let's have a look and see. King of Cups coming in here and the Knight of Cups. You see, you need to be a little bit careful here. If this is you, this person is more flirty than serious. Okay, you got a Knight of Pentacles here. It was in the reverse position, okay? And you got the Knight of Cups here in the reverse position as well. They don't mind coming in here flirting and all those kinds of things. But it's in the reverse position. It's more flirting than stability. You see, they come in, they enjoy having the fun and they enjoy talking over the phone or messaging, flirting. But stability, they're not really interested in. It's more just like fun, you know? Oh, this is fun. This is like entertainment. Oh, excuse me, guys. And the problem is here, when they are doing this, I feel like they're making you fall in love with them. You see? And then, I don't know if you've confronted them about this. Like, oh, what do you want from me? I mean, what is going on between me and you? Maybe it's time you do. Maybe it's time you like kind of ask them, what exactly is happening with me and you? What are we to each other? What is the situation? Don't be afraid to ask. Sometimes we're afraid to ask because we're hoping that somebody will either come in stronger, or somebody will fall in love with us along the road, or somebody will realize they can't live without us. No, you need to be very clear on what is going on in a situation. Otherwise, people will keep on just doing what they're doing. They won't have any like responsibility, you know, because you're not making them responsible. You need to ask exactly what's going on and find out exactly what this person wants with you. And if they're going, I'm interested somewhere, maybe in 2027, I'm thinking of settling down. And you're like, 2027? Really? And they're like, yeah, you know, I've got some goals to reach in my life. I don't want to get settled down now. And you're not interested in that. You're not interested in just being on and off for 7 years of your life. Then you need to know exactly what's going on with your life. You know what I'm saying? I am just saying, because I kind of pick up this vibe of in and out. They're there. There's not really a bad energy from them. It's not like they're doing something to you. They're just not there when, like, normal. You know what I mean? So let's see today's question. Now, this one gets me. Hello, your name, this is what's getting me. I don't know how to say your name, but I'm going to try my best. If I destroy it, do not come down on me. But it is for Alok Mishra. Tell me I said that right. Alok Mishra. Okay. You are Pisces and you are asking, will you ever get true love? My goodness, ladies, look at the single man over here. I'm just saying. But let's see, Alok, will you find true love? It's hard, hey? It's hard to find somebody that you connect with and that you can actually be with. I think somebody opened my gate. Somebody like rocked up at my house here. But anyway, my son is here. So let's have a look and see. For you, Alok, are you going to be able to find like true love or love that is long-lasting, you know, that person that's there for you? You have to. You're still young, you know. So let's have a look and see. Even if you're older, I mean, the thing is, age doesn't really matter. So let's have a look and see. The Ten of Voices. Geez, you've been hurt. You have been hurt, but this is now in the past. You've had a lot of people hurting you. Like, they did things to hurt you, to break your heart. Yes, somebody is coming in here. Who is this? You got a... Yes. If you've been in my readings before, this card is the Six of Wands or the Six of Inspiration. It's my card of the soulmate. And you're asking, am I going to find true love? Yes, you are. And finally, it's like you've been waiting for so long. It's like, you know, you've had to heal from that. The Four of Swords talks about needing to heal. But that's over now. And you got the Six of Inspiration coming in here, which is... soulmate recognition. You are going to meet a soulmate. Yes, Alok. And you are definitely going to be meeting a soulmate. Just keep on doing the healing, but I feel like it's not going to be for very long because the Swords energy is very quick. When you meet this person, you will know. You will know who this is. Meeting them, you're going to know. That's them. You will recognize them. You'll feel it in your body, your heart, your soul. You're going to feel it like maybe... like as a reaction that goes through your body, like a recognition of somebody, because this is recognizing somebody's soul. Okay, most probably past life connection. I'm just saying. Let's have a look and see. Ten of Pentacles is here as well, and the Five of Pentacles. This is not an ex. I am just saying, if you're wondering if this is an ex, no, this is coming in extremely quickly. Okay, it's not an ex. It's not an ex. I feel like this is associated. The Five of Pentacles talks about something that has been lost. And the Ten of Pentacles is stability that got lost as well. It's not there anymore. It is not an ex. Just making sure of that one. Let's see what else will come through. It is a new person. You got a Ten of Pentacles on the bottom of the deck. It's a new person that's coming in quickly. Not an ex person. And you're going to actually most probably get married. Settle down. I'm just saying, you know, have bills to pay and a mortgage and school fees and stuff like that. But there we go. Thank you so much for asking the question. Yes, you got a true love coming in. You got a soulmate that's coming in here. And it's very soon. It is not long from now. Like literally a couple of maybe weeks before the end of this year even. I am just saying. So there we go. And it's not an ex. It's not the people who have done this. So if they do come back in here, just keep pushing them out. Otherwise, you're going to keep on dealing with somebody from your ex, from your past, and you're not allowing the space to happen around you to allow the person who is meant to come in. You see what I'm saying? Thank you so much. I'm sending my love in your direction. And if you want to have your question answered, comment below with your zodiac sign and check back in the next day or two. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.